Theory of operation. Number one, oxygen enters the machine at the lower back of flow meter. Number two, oxygen exits flow meter near top. Number three, the oxygen enters the vaporizer and collects anesthetic gas. Number four, the oxygen and anesthetic exits the vaporizer. Number five, oxygen and anesthetic enters the reservoir bag and inhalation tube, then is inhaled by the patient. Number six, the patient exhales. Waste gas enters the machine. Number seven, waste gas enters the CO2 absorber canister, which removes the CO2. Number eight, gas without CO2 enters the reservoir bag, inhalation tube, and patient recycling the gas. Number nine, a small amount of waste gas exits the APL valve, maintaining pressure in machine and patient's lungs at 1 to 3 centimeters H2O. Oxygen flush. Number 1. Oxygen enters the machine at the lower back of flow meter. Number 2. Pressing the button on the oxygen flush valve bypasses the vaporizer. Number 3. Oxygen enters the reservoir bag and inhalation tube, then is inhaled by the patient. Number 4. The patient exhales. Waste gas enters the machine. Number 5. Waste gas enters the CO2 absorber canister, which removes the CO2. Number 6. Oxygen without CO2 enters the reservoir bag, inhalation tube, and patient, recycling the oxygen. Number 7. A small amount of waste gas exits the APL valve, maintaining pressure in the machine and patient's lungs at 1 to 3 centimeters H2O. Safety valve. Number 1. If there is no oxygen in the tank or the flow is shut off at the flow meter, room air enters the machine through the safety valve. The patient does not receive anesthetic gas. Number 2. During inhalation, the reservoir bag deflates first, then the air from the safety valve is drawn into the system. Number 3. The patient exhales. Waste gas enters the machine. Number 4. Waste gas enters the CO2 absorber canister, which removes the CO2. Number 5. Air without CO2 enters the reservoir bag, inhalation tube, and patient, recycling the air. Number 6. A small amount of waste gas exits the APL valve.